Hey guys, this is Aarti and welcome to Aarti's Kitchen. Today we'll be making a chicken dish, that is today we'll be making chicken kadai. So for our chicken kadai, firstly we need to prepare a type of masala. So for our masala, we have heated up a pan. Into our pan we'll drop in some dried red chilies. Just separate the stock. Around 5 to 6 red chilies. Next we add in our coriander seeds, around a tablespoonful, cumin seeds, 1 tablespoon, and lastly 2 sticks of cinnamon. Roast all our spices. Our spices are now roasted well. Next we'll grind these spices and prepare a masala out of it. So guys, here our masala for our chicken kadai is now ready. And next we start preparing our recipe. Next we'll marinate our chicken. Here we have around 500 grams of chicken. Into it we'll drop in our masala which we had prepared. Reserve half of it for our gravy. Next we drop in a tablespoonful of ginger, garlic and chili paste. Next we add in around a teaspoon of turmeric powder, around a teaspoon of salt, juice of half a lemon. Mix it all well together. Next we'll set our chicken into our refrigerator for around half an hour. So now we start preparing our chicken kadai. We'll heat up a pan first. Drop in our oil, 4 tablespoons of oil. When our oil is heated up, we'll add in our whole spices. Firstly, we have your 3 bay leaves, 4 to 5 green cardamom, black cardamom, and lastly our cloves. Let them sizzle it a bit. Next, we add in our onions, 2 medium sized onions which we had cut into cubes. We do not need to change the color of our onions. We just need to saute them for a while. Our onions are now sauteed well. Next we add in our ginger and garlic paste. Next we add in our tomatoes. 2 tomatoes cut into cubes. Let the tomatoes turn soft. Our tomatoes are getting soft now. Next we add in our green chilies, 4 green chilies, the masala which we had reserved from before. Cover it with the lid. Drop in some salt, a teaspoonful, and let the tomatoes cook further. Our tomatoes are now nice and soft. And next we'll add in our marinated chicken. Cover it with a lid. And next we'll simmer our chicken for around 10 to 15 minutes till the chicken releases all its juices. As you all can see, our chicken has now started releasing its juices. And very lastly into our chicken we'll add in our green bell pepper. We'll not overcook our bell pepper, let it remain a bit crispy. Cover our pan with a lid and let our chicken cook for further 5 minutes, not more than that. So guys, here our chicken kadai is now ready. Switch off the flame. Do not cook it further, because we want our green peppers to be a bit crispy and not overcooked. So our chicken kadai is now cooked, and next we'll serve it. So guys, our chicken kadai is now ready. So if you like the recipe, do give it a thumbs up and like, share and subscribe to Aarti's Kitchen. And thank you for watching. Guys, this is Aarti and welcome to Aarti's Kitchen. Today we'll be making restaurant style chicken do pyaza. The list of ingredients is displayed. If you all have any queries regarding it, you all can drop me your comments in the comment section below. So let's get started. Firstly, we have heated in some oil in our pan. To it, we'll add in our 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, and now we'll add in our sliced onions. These are around 2 medium sized onions sliced here. You all can also use chopped onions if you all want to. We'll cook the onions till they turn into a dark golden shade. To our onions, we'll add in 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Our onions are getting cooked, and now we'll add in 4 to 5 green chilies to it. Our onions are nice and golden now. Now we'll add in 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste, 'Give it a stir. At this stage, you need to ensure that your onions do not get burned, so keep stirring them constantly. And now we'll add in our spices. Here we won't add our spices directly to our onions. We'll add in our spices to this buttermilk and then add it to our onions. So first, we have 1/2 cup of buttermilk here. To it, we'll add in 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1 tablespoon of red chili powder, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1/2 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1/2 teaspoon of cumin powder, and then mix this, and then we'll add it to our onions. You all can also add in some yogurt or curd instead of buttermilk. Our buttermilk will enhance the flavors of our spices and then make the gravy more tastier. And now we'll add in our tomato puree. This is a puree of around 2 medium sized tomatoes. Mix this well. And then let it cook for around 5 minutes. Our gravy is almost cooked now. And now we'll add in our chicken. This is around 500 grams of chicken we have used here. And now we'll cover our chicken with the lid and let it cook for further 10 minutes or till the chicken is fully cooked. Cover the chicken with the lid and keep it on a low medium flame. And now our chicken is almost cooked. At this stage, we'll add in juice of
a whole lemon and 1 teaspoon of garam masala powder. And now we'll add in some chopped coriander. Meanwhile, our chicken is getting cooked. Here in a kadai, we'll heat in some oil. To this, we'll add in 4 to 5 dried red chilies. And 2 onions, which we have cut into cubes. Give this a stir. We'll switch off the flame after 2 to 3 minutes and drop this onions to our chicken. And we do not want the onions to get fully cooked, so we'll off the flame even here. And then cover our chicken with the lid so the onions get transparent with the heat in the chicken itself. So guys, our restaurant style chicken do pyaza is now ready and it looks delicious, and now we'll serve it. So guys, our restaurant style chicken do pyaza is now ready, and if you like the recipe, please like, share and subscribe to Aarti's Kitchen, and do try this recipe and inform me how it turned out. Thank you for watching.
Hello guys, this is Aarti and welcome to Aarti's Kitchen. Today we'll be making chicken handi, so let's get started. Firstly, we have heated in some oil in a pan. This is around 6 to 7 tablespoons of oil which we are heating here. And now that our oil is heated, we'll drop in 2 medium sized onion which we had sliced here. We'll fry the onions till they are nice and brown. Now that our onions have turned brown, we'll remove them and set them aside on a plate. Remove the excess oil. And now in the same oil, we'll drop in some garlic and green chilies. We have here around 6 to 7 cloves of garlic and 4 to 5 green chilies which we had chopped. We'll saute the garlic and green chilies. Next, we'll drop in our tomatoes, 2 medium sized tomatoes. We'll cook the tomatoes till they are nice and soft. You can increase the flame now to medium high. So our tomatoes are now getting cooked. To our tomatoes, we'll add in a tablespoonful of ginger and garlic paste, some coriander seeds which we had crushed. Our tomatoes are now nice and soft. Into our tomatoes, next we'll drop in our fried onions now. Give them a mix. Next, we add in our spices. Firstly, a teaspoonful of salt, 2 teaspoons of red chili powder, 1/2 a teaspoon of turmeric powder. Our remaining coriander seeds, we'll give it a mix now. We have dropped in our chicken now. Mix our chicken well. We'll let the chicken cook nicely. Cover it with a lid. Now our chicken is almost done. You all can see that the oil has separated from the chicken and coated the chicken well. Next, we'll drop in some dried fenugreek into it. This is also known as kasturi methi. Next, we'll add in our beaten curd, around 3/4 cup. And next, we have here our cashew nut paste. We had soaked around 10 to 12 cashew nuts and then grinded them into a fine paste. Some more fenugreek. You all can also add in cream instead of our cashew nut paste. Give it a nice mix. Now we'll cover our chicken with a lid and let it cook for further 10 to 15 minutes. So guys, our chicken is now almost done. And lastly, we'll add in a tablespoon full of garam masala. Give it a quick mix. We'll cover it with our lid for 2 to 3 minutes and then we'll switch off the flame. So guys, our chicken handi is done now and we'll serve it now. So guys, here our chicken handi is now ready. So if you like the recipe, do give it a thumbs up and like, share and subscribe to my channel, that is Aarti's Kitchen. And thank you for watching. Hey guys, this is Aarti and welcome to Aarti's Kitchen. Today we'll be making a chicken recipe, that is today we'll be making chicken masala. So for our chicken masala, firstly we have heated up a pan. Into it we'll drop in some oil, around 2 to 3 tablespoons. Next we drop in our cumin seeds, around 1 teaspoon. Next we drop in our onions, around 2 medium sized onions which we had thinly sliced. Saute them well. Our onions have turned translucent now. Next we drop in our ginger garlic paste, around a tablespoonful. Mix it well with our onions. Next we drop in around 4 green chilies, half cut. Next we drop in our tomatoes which we had cut into julienne. This is around 1 large tomato we have used here. Cook the tomato till it is nice and soft. Next we drop in our spices. Firstly, 1 teaspoon of salt, red chili powder, around a tablespoonful, turmeric powder, half a teaspoon, garam masala, a tablespoonful. Mix everything well together. Next, we add in our bell pepper, 1/4 cup of bell pepper. Next, we add in some water, around half a cup. Put on the lid of our pan and let all the vegetables cook for a while. Our vegetables are now well cooked. Next, we drop in around half a teaspoon of coriander seeds powder. Mix it well. So our masala is now ready. And lastly, we'll drop in our chicken. This is around 500 grams of chicken we are using here. Mix the masala and the chicken all well together. And then put on the lid and let the chicken simmer for around 15 minutes. So after 15 to 20 minutes, our chicken is now done. So guys, our chicken masala is now ready and next we'll serve it. So guys, our chicken masala is now ready and we have served it here. So if you like the recipe, do give it a big fat thumbs up and like, share and subscribe to Aarti's Kitchen. And thank you so much for watching.